A guest on DBS's News Make Alive program, accountant Frank Myers, has suggested that the head of the Royal Saint Lucia Police Force not be chosen from its ranks. The structure of the force, he says, needs to be changed to bring a fresh approach to crime fighting. As long as the individual has the competence, says Myers, whether foreign or local, they should be considered.
The Commission of Police, in my mind, does not necessarily have to be a policeman. Effectively, what you need is a good manager, because you need to manage all those resources that you have. And when you have that, and that person has a vision as to where he wants to go, you give him the resources he needs. And if it doesn't work out, then you get somebody who can do it. It's just like any organization. You have your policies, you give him the resources, and he knows what you want, he knows what the country wants, and he works with the executive and the legislative to get things going. But we don't necessarily need a career policeman, because we'd have it over the years. We've had these guys being injected from the bottom, and they don't seem to have it, because it seems to be the right, just like the public service, that once I stay there for 20 years, I have to rise to the top.
According to Myers, the leadership of the force over the years has been questionable.
We've had some good police chiefs, we've had some bad ones, but overall it has been questionable. The police, the country is very suspicious of policemen. Because a police force can only, and in fact any law enforcement agency can only work with the support of the community. And to the extent that the community don't have any confidence in you, and confidence in the anonymity, confidence when I tell you something, it'll go no further, but you do what you have to do. It's going to all go for naught. We have to find a way around that sort of thing. Now, there's a suggestion that during the old days, that's even older than me, when the British ran the region and the policemen were transferable between islands, there's a perception that things worked better because you would have people working in countries that they have no connection to, and so they are impartial in the way things are working. Possibly the time may be there to bring that back. We have the OECS, we cooperate on all sorts of areas. Why not cooperate on law and order? And have this transferability between the islands. What's lacking in the police force is that insult, that they don't seem to feel the insult when something happens on their watch. You don't get that feeling, I am going to get the person who does that. They don't do it. There seems to be no urge to say it's not going to happen here. The guy who was in Trinidad, Gary Griffith, he had that approach.
The recruitment process for the force will also need to be switched up if its image is to change, says Myers.
I've been of the opinion that we should try and get the best people available to come into the force. In other words, go to the A-level college. Not everybody that's going to go off to a university or can afford to go off to a university. Make it mandatory to get into the force. You need at least two A-levels. So you have a trainable person. You have a trainable person, and you use a combination of scholarships and long service to keep people moving interested. You'll get some to stay in. But we'll get away from some of the stuff you see on Facebook. Saw recently a guy trying to pull a gun from somewhere and he almost blew his toe off. You don't want that in a police force. You need to have people who will walk up to you and talk to you in a sensible way when you're doing something.
The manner in which the Royal Saint Lucia Police Force fights crime will need to be changed. And in order for this to happen, says Myers, it too will need to take a different approach. For the DBS News World, I am Zane Romulus.